Did anyone notice that this door is ajar? Now, it's just this kind of little opening that would allow the dark forces to attack us faster than Gloria James on a parking valet. Well, maybe I can just pull it closed with my teeth. Oh, wait, no, no. Well, as long as it's open, I might as well investigate out here. Although I don't smell any magical residue yet. Maybe I should just check to see if the windows are open.
Oh, look, the porch door is open.
That can't be good.
Maybe this is how our little saboteur got into the house. Now if we could only find out where he's hiding.
Oh, hey, Trey. I thought Honey said she was going to keep a close eye on Tippy so she could let us know the next time that crab fella makes an appearance.
Is that true, Honey? Are you supposed to be shadowing Tippy?
Yes, I was, but then I got distracted by a chickpea and, well...
Leave it to Honey to let food come before duty. I mean, what kind of simpleton gets distracted by a chickpea?
Oh, I'm sure it could happen to anyone, Honey.
Yeah, anyone that has the sensibility of a gluttonous sloth.
But you really should try to find her.
All right, I'm going. Gee!
It's weird. I'm so tired, but I still haven't been able to sleep very well lately. I keep tossing and turning.
That's understandable. Are you worried about the intruder?
No, I'm worried that Donald Trump may actually run for president and turn this country into the United States of Apprentices.
Don't worry. He may have money and power and connections, but when has that ever won anyone an election? I'm being facetious, of course.
Hey, Mr. Trey, what's going on?
Oh, nothing. Excuse me.
Oh, hey, Boots, you're in here too, eh? I didn't realize it was porch season already.
Well, what do we have here? Boots and Tuck alone on the porch together? How convenient! Perhaps it's time I gave them a taste of their own medicine.
Now, Tippy, before you go ballistic on Boots and Tuck, there's something you should know.
Don't bother. I'm tired of everyone making excuses for bad behavior. So now it's time for Mel Gibson and Charlie Sheen out there to learn a little lesson.
Hello, everyone. We only have a few minutes before we begin the attack. And I want to make sure everyone knows exactly what they're supposed to be doing. We don't want any more screw-ups like we've had in the past. So please make sure all your mechanics are well-oiled. We don't want anyone breaking down in the heat of battle. Is that understood?
Hey, what's this? Sounds like that little purple puppet person is assembling some kind of army. I'd better find out what he's up to before I go warn the others.
Now, Tippy, I really think you should think about what...
There we go!
What? Why did you shut the porch door?
So they can stay out there and think about what they've done.
Hey, Tippy just shut the door. Now why would she do that? I guess she must have forgot I can't use my magic to open up doors.
I understand your anger, but these are dangerous times, and as for your friend Crab,
Don't you dare say anything bad about him! He's the only one around here honest enough to tell me the truth!
Hey, Tippy, why'd you shut us out? Look, we're sorry for what we did, but it wasn't really our fault. We were under a dark influence. Tippy, open the door. Tippy, I don't have the power to protect you when I'm out here. Tippy, please open this door now.
Tippy, come on, this isn't funny. You don't realize what's going on. Mr. Trey filled me in and now everything makes sense.
Yeah, nonsense, because that's about all that comes out of anyone's mouth around here. And believe me, as soon as Crad has made all the arrangements, I am off to Hollywood to seek my fame and fortune.
But Tippy, Crad is not who you think he is.
Don't care. Don't want to hear it.
You don't understand. He works for the...
Tippy, please, listen to me.
That does it. Tippy is obviously in one of her stubborn moods, so we're going to have to figure out how to open this door ourselves.
Oh, I can just about reach the handle. Let's see if there's some kind of rope or something we could pull it with.
Maybe we could wrap this orange towel up like a sushi roll and throw it over the handle like a pulley. Or better yet, if I could stand on your shoulders, I could probably reach it myself. And, oh wait, I just remembered. The door locks from the other side.
Oh, crap.
Okay, you all know which cat you're supposed to target. Now, once you've captured them, take them to the basement for processing. And remember, Tippy is off limits. We have very special plans for her, and therefore she should not be harmed in any way. As for the rest of them, well, you know how I feel about blood. Not already. Pick up on aisle 7.
I wonder why Tippy is exempt from this. But there's no time to ponder. I've got to warn the others. I wish I hadn't used all my transport allotment for the day, though, because now I have to get around the old-fashioned way. Manually.
Tippy, please open the door. You don't realize what kind of danger you're putting us all in.
Oh, please, I don't believe you anymore. There's no guardians or ladders or dark forces. You probably just made it all up to make me look like a fool, didn't you?
Oh, Tippy, you don't know how wrong you are.
Don't you try to Oshkosh-bagosh me anymore. I'm out of here.
Tippy, please, I'm begging you. Let us out of here now, before it's too late.